Okay, again, good day to all grade 10 students of Pablo S. Villaverde High School. Again, this is your science teacher, Sir Eduardo D. Malio Jr. And for this video, we are going to tackle about the Quarter 2 Module 8, wherein we are going to focus more on the applications or the uses of ultraviolet, x-rays, and gamma rays. And I hope you are enjoying from the Module 1 up to this Module 8. And our most essential learning competency, cite examples of practical applications of the different regions of EM waves. And for our targets or our objectives, number one, define or describe ultraviolet radiation, X-ray, and gamma ray. Number two, differentiate and compare ultraviolet radiation, X-ray, and gamma ray. Number three, identify some uses of ultraviolet radiation, X-ray, and gamma ray. Sun is the main source of energy in Earth. It is also the main source of ultraviolet radiation, though some are made artificially. There are some ultraviolet radiation that are made in laboratory. In hospitals, gamma rays and x-rays are used to diagnose and treat diseases. These types of EM waves can be useful or can also be dangerous depending on the use. Before we proceed to the different exploratory activities, again, we are going to try answering these pretests. Okay, number one, what type of EM waves is used in sterilizing water from drinking fountains? Okay, what is your guess? Okay, the correct answer is UV radiation. And number two, what is the main source of ultraviolet radiation in Earth? Okay, is it letter A, sun, letter B, star, C, moon, letter D, asteroid? Okay, the correct answer is letter A. Number three, where are X-rays produced? Letter A, X-ray funnel. Letter B, X-ray tube. Letter C, X-ray metal. D, X-ray wire. Okay, the correct answer is letter B, X-ray tube. Okay, let us now proceed to the next page. Who discovered X-ray? Okay, I've already discussed this in Module 1 about the history or the development of the electromagnetic wave theory. So your answer will be letter A, Wilhelm Conrad Roentgen. Okay, number 5. What EM wave has the shortest wavelength and has the highest frequency? If you are familiar with the Module 3, wherein we discuss more about the member of the electromagnetic spectrum family, it lies at the end of the electromagnetic spectrum family, that is the correct gamma ray. Okay, number 6. How is ultraviolet radiation different from visible light in terms of wavelengths? Letter A, ultraviolet radiation has shorter wavelengths than the visible light. Letter B, ultraviolet radiation has longer wavelengths than visible light. Letter C, ultraviolet radiation and visible light have the same wavelengths. Letter D, ultraviolet radiation has either shorter or longer wavelengths than visible light. Okay, what is your answer? Okay, letter A, ultraviolet radiation has shorter wavelengths than the visible light. Okay, number 7, what is the frequency of X-rays? Letter A, 3 times 10 raised to 16, 2, 3 times 10 raised to 19. Letter B, 3 times 10 raised to 17, to 3 times 10 raised to 20 hertz. That is, the unit of this is hertz. Letter C, 3 times 10 raised to 18, to 3 times 10 raised to 21. And letter D, 3 times 10 raised to 19, to 3 times 10 raised to 22. Okay, the correct answer is letter A. Okay, number 8. Aside from the sun and the stars, what can produce gamma rays? Letter A, oxygen. B, metals. C, radioactive substances. D, minerals. Okay, the correct answer is letter C, radioactive substances. Number 9. All of the following are uses of ultraviolet rays except letter A, production of vitamin D in our skin. Letter B, sterilization of water in drinking fountains. Letter C, identifying original from fake banknotes. Letter D, killing cancer cells. Okay, the correct answer is letter D, killing cancer cells. Number 10, how are X-rays produced? Letter A, X-rays are produced when fast-moving electrons hit a metal target. Letter B, X-rays are produced when fast-moving protons hit a metal target. Letter C, X-rays are produced when fast-moving electrons hit a non-metal target. Letter D, X-rays are produced when fast-moving protons hit a non-metal target. Okay, the correct answer is letter A. Okay, let us now proceed to the next page. Okay, in this page, direction, identify the EM waves being described by the statement below, writing UV for ultraviolet radiation, XR for X-ray, GR for gamma ray. Number one, lies beyond the violet end of the visible spectrum. What do you think is the correct answer? Okay, the correct answer is UV ray. So I'm not going to give all the correct answer from 1 to 15. I'm only giving you some bonuses answers here. So let's try number two. Comes just after the ultraviolet rays. Okay, this is blank. You will be the one to answer this. Number three, gives tanning effect. Okay, this is also blank. So as we go further with our discussion, I am sure that this 1 to 15, you will get all the correct answers. Okay, number 4. Lies on the other end of the electromagnetic spectrum. We have the bonus answer. We have the gamma ray. Number 5. Very strong that they can kill living cells. Okay, another blank. Number 6. Dangerous because they can damage healthy living cells of the body. Okay, the correct answer is X-ray. Number 7, frequency higher than that of the visible light but lower than the X-rays. Okay, another blank. Number 8, produces vitamin D in our skin. Okay, another blank. Number 9, frequent exposure can cause cancer over time. Okay, again, another blank. Number 10, can penetrate soft and hard body tissues. Okay, another blank. Number 11, used to kill cancer cells. Okay, the correct answer is gamma ray. Number 12, identify original from fake banknotes. Okay, UV ray. 13, can pass through soft tissues but are filtered by dense matter like bones. Okay, the answer is blank. Answer number 14, filtered out the frequencies by the use of sunblock. Okay, blank again. 15, okay, we have UV, can burn skin and eyes. You have 6 bonus answers, so you will be finding the 9 more answers from 1 to 15. Okay, good luck everybody. Okay, let us now proceed to another activity. Pick me up. Directions. Complete the table below, or not below, this one, at the right part, by picking and writing the correct information about the 3 types of EM waves, the UV radiation, X-ray, and gamma ray, found on the boxes below. So you're going to get your answers from these 2 boxes. Okay, for example, I'm going to give you a sample answer. In this column, wavelength, note, right, short, shorter, or shortest among the 3. For example, UV ray is short. Okay, the next one, X-ray, blank. Gamma ray, blank. So you will be the one to give the answer. So the remaining answer should be shorter or shortest in between the 2, the X-ray and gamma ray. Okay, the next one, frequency. Right, high, higher, or highest. Let us check if we have the bonus answer. Okay, blank for UV radiation. Okay, higher for X-ray. And blank for gamma ray. Okay, for energy. Note, you are going to write high, higher, highest. Let us check if we have bonus answer. Okay, blank for UV radiation. Okay, higher for X-ray. And blank again for gamma ray. And for the useful applications and harmful effects, you have to write the letters. Useful applications of UV radiation, we have A, production of vitamin D in our skin, and you still have another 3 blanks here. So you have to write down the letters of the correct answers here of the useful applications. What about an X-ray? Okay, we have blank. Gamma ray, we have 2. We have given E, used in sterilizing medical equipment, and what else? So you will be the one to give the answer. Okay, harmful effects. For UV radiation, we have J and blank. So another one. X-ray, okay, we have 1 blank. And gamma ray, okay, maybe if you can find harmful effects in gamma ray, you may answer here. Okay, let us now proceed to the next page. What is ultraviolet radiation? Okay, we are going now to define what is an ultraviolet radiation. So it lies just beyond the violet end of the visible spectrum. So this is the visible spectrum. So red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet, the end of the visible radiation. The next one is the UV, the ultraviolet radiation. The ultraviolet waves have shorter wavelengths than the visible light and carry more energy. Ultraviolet radiation is the part of the electromagnetic spectrum that consists of frequencies higher than that of the visible light. but lower than X-ray. So in terms of frequency, the UV ray is higher than the visible light, but lower than the X-ray. Having higher frequency, UV rays carry higher amount of energy. Okay, as we discussed in the module 3, the higher the frequency, the higher the energy. So they can damage tissue, burn the skin, and damage the eyes. For these reasons, protection from such damaging rays were invented, such as like UV sunscreen, sunblock, lotions, and eyeglasses that could filter out these frequencies. So too much exposure to sunlight make our skin absorbs more amount of UV ray. So too much amount of UV ray that prone to the so-called skin cancer. That's why we are now using some lotions, materials that can be able to reduce the amount of UV rays that our skin absorbs. Ultraviolet rays also have benefits. Hospitals make use of UV to sterilize medical instrument to kill harmful bacteria, as you can see in these pictures. Okay, another uses of UV rays, number one, production of vitamin D in our skin. It's also important for us to be exposed in sunlight because as we know that vitamin D is very important in our body. So UV rays also produces vitamin D. So helps in the production of vitamin D in our skin. So just avoid too much amount. Number two, sterilization of water in drinking fountains. And number three, identifying original from fake banknotes. So by using UV ray, or some gasoline stations, mall, banks, they can be able to identify the fake original ones. So those were the uses of UV rays. Let us now proceed to the next one, the X-rays. Okay, X-rays come just after ultraviolet rays. So if we are going to compare the wavelength, they are of shorter wavelength but carries higher energy than the UV. So it has the shorter wavelength but carry the higher amount of energy compared to the UV ray. So X-rays are produced using an X-ray tube. They are emitted when fast-moving electrons hit a metal target. Okay, X-rays discovered by Wilhelm Conrad Röntgen in 1895. And if we are going to read the history in the discovery of Wilhelm Conrad Röntgen, he named it as X-ray because he cannot be able to identify what kind of ray. That's why he letter X. When we say X in mathematical expressions, when we say X, that is unknown ray for Wilhelm Conrad Röntgen. That was in 1895. So until now, we are using X-ray as its name. The long wavelength X-rays, this one can penetrate the flesh but not the bones. So they are used in X-ray photography to help the doctors look inside the body. They are useful in diagnosing bone fractures and tumors. The short wavelength X-ray can penetrate even through metals. They are used in industry to inspect welded joints for faults in buildings. So by means of short wavelength X-ray, they can be able to identify which part of the building is not properly installed or not properly welded. All X-rays are dangerous because they can damage healthy living cells of the body. This is the reason why frequent exposure to X-rays should be avoided. So too much exposure to X-rays can damage body tissues and can cause cancer. And too much exposure of our gonads or the reproductive parts or can cause infertility. Or the frequencies of X-rays range from 3 times 10 raised to 19 hertz. Okay, let us now proceed to gamma rays. Among the members of the electromagnetic spectrum family, gamma rays lie at the other end of the electromagnetic spectrum. It has the shortest wavelength and of course, the highest in frequency. Because if we are going back to the module 3, the wavelength is inversely proportional to the frequency. As the wavelength becomes shorter, the frequency and then the energy become higher. So that is the characteristics of gamma rays. It has the shortest wavelength, but it has the highest frequency, and of course, it carries the highest amount of energy. Thus, they are more dangerous. Or gamma rays are emitted by stars and some radioactive substances. For example, the uranium. Uranium and some other radioactive materials are used in electricity production or the so-called the nuclear power plant. That's why, as you can observe in the nuclear power plant, it is covered with thick concrete. So, because the thick concrete and lead can block the gamma rays to avoid people in that area to be exposed to gamma rays. So, gamma rays are very strong that they can kill living cells. Gamma rays are used to treat cancer through the process called radiotherapy. They are also used for sterilization of drinking water, the so-called food preservation or the food irradiation. Instead of putting chemicals to preserve the foods, the technology today to preserve the foods, the fruits from other countries to be delivered to our country, undergo the so-called food irradiation, will be exposed to gamma rays to kill the bacteria inside fruits without sacrificing the quality of fruits. So the gamma ray is one of the radioactive material. Okay, we have three radioactive material in radioactive substances. We have the alpha, beta, and gamma. And the gamma ray has the highest penetrating power, as you can see in this picture. It has the highest penetrating power because of the energy it carries. Okay, let us now proceed to the next one. Apply what you have learned, true or false. Okay, directions, write the word true if the statement is correct and false if the statement is incorrect or wrong. Write your answer on this separate sheet of paper or in your activity notebook. Okay, I'm going to give one bonus answer. That is true. Overexposure to UV radiation may cause skin cancer. So the 1 to 9, you will be the one to give the answer. Okay, good luck. I hope you will get the perfect score in these quizzes. Okay, reflect. I have learned that. Okay, what are you learning? Again, you can comment here in our comment box. Write your answer in your activity notebook. Oh, I wish to ask my teacher, what do you want to clarify more about this lesson? And for the reinforcement, watch a short video clip about the benefits of the UV radiation, X-ray, and gamma ray on YouTube by clicking the following. Okay, number two, give at least 5 useful applications of UV radiation, X-ray, and gamma rays. Okay, next, this is now the word bank or the vocabulary words. Number one, UV radiation is a part of the electromagnetic spectrum that consists of frequencies higher than that of visible light but lower than the X-rays. An electromagnetic wave of high energy and very short wavelength, which is able to pass through many materials opaque to light. When you say opaque, these are the materials that light cannot pass through but X-ray can pass through. Gamma rays, penetrating electromagnetic radiation arising from the radioactive decay of atomic nuclei. Sterilization, the process of making something free from bacteria or other living microorganisms. Tanning is the process in which the skin becomes brown or browner after exposure to the sun. Fractures, the cracking or breaking of hard object or material like bone. Tumor, a swelling of a part of the body, generally without inflammation, caused by an abnormal growth of tissue, whether benign or malignant. Fluorescence, the visible or invisible radiation emitted by certain substance as a result of incident radiation. Let us now proceed to the assessment. Okay, we have 10 assessment questions. Okay, you will be the one to answer all these questions. Number one, this EM wave consists of frequencies higher than that of the visible light but lower than the X-ray. Okay, letter A, gamma ray. B, radio wave. Letter C, X-ray. Letter D, UV radiation. Number two, what two EM waves lie on the other end of the spectrum with very high frequencies and energies? Letter A, gamma rays and microwaves. Letter B, visible light and gamma rays. Letter C, X-rays and UV radiation. Letter D, X-rays and gamma rays. Number three, which electromagnetic wave penetrates soft and hard tissues? Letter A, gamma rays. Letter B, X-rays. Letter C, UV radiation. Letter D, infrared. Okay, number four. Why are X-rays suitable for diagnosing one fracture and dense tumor? Letter A, because they can pass through soft tissues but are filtered by dense matter such as the bones. Letter B, because they cannot penetrate soft tissues. Letter C, because they can penetrate soft tissues and dense matter such as bones. Letter D, because they cannot penetrate dense matter such as muscles and bones. Number five, which is a useful application of gamma radiation? Letter A, used in the production of vitamin D in our skin. Letter B, used in sterilizing water in drinking fountains. Letter C, used in diagnosing bone fractures. Letter D, used to kill cancer cells. Okay, number six, how is the frequency of UV radiation different from gamma rays? Letter A, the frequency of UV radiation is higher than gamma rays. Letter B, the frequency of UV radiation is the same with gamma rays. Letter C, the frequency of UV radiation is lower than gamma rays. Letter D, the frequency of UV radiation may be higher or may be lower depending on the amount of energy. Number 7, what is the correct arrangement of the three EM waves based on decreasing energy. Again, decreasing energy. Letter A, UV radiation, X-ray, gamma ray. Letter B, gamma ray, UV radiation, X-ray. Letter C, X-ray, gamma ray, UV radiation. Letter D, gamma ray, X-ray, UV radiation. Number 8, from the 3 EM waves, which is the most dangerous if exposure is too much? Letter A, gamma rays. Letter B, X-rays. Letter C, UV radiation. Letter D, both A and C. Number 9, in what year was X-ray discovered by Wilhelm Conrad Roentgen? Letter A, 1896. Letter B, 1895. Letter C, 1894. Letter D, 1893. And for the last question, why are all X-rays dangerous? Letter A, because they can damage healthy living cells of the body. Letter B, because they can break bones if exposed too much. Letter C, because they can burn your skin. Letter D, because they can damage your eyes if exposed for longer period of time. Okay, good luck to everyone for our next video lesson. We are going to tackle the module 9, wherein we are going to focus more on the effects of EM radiation on living things in the environment. So I hope you all enjoyed this video lesson. And again, thank you. This is Sir Eduardo D. Malia Jr. Thank you for watching. Good luck.